Hey everybody, welcome back to the Mac Whisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And if you're one of those people who constantly misplaces your phone, your keys, or even your children, then this video is just for you. Ever since cell phones have existed, human beings have been misplacing them. Sometimes they're in the car or under the couch cushions, or we left it at the restaurant down the street, or it's in one of our old jackets. When someone loses their phone, they usually call it, which isn't super effective because frequently it's on silent mode, or the volume's down, or the battery's dead. There's a better way. Find My. The Find My app is pre-installed on all iPhones, iPads, and Apple computers, and it can still help you find your lost iPhone. But it can also help you locate your lost AirPods, your misplaced iPad, or even a computer. But Apple didn't stop there. Find My can also help you track your friends and family, with their permission, of course, as well as the most recent addition, the ability to use Apple's AirTag handheld trackers to track items like your backpack, your bike, or your keys. In today's session, I'm going to teach you how to find a lost device, how to locate a family member or friend, and how to use AirTags to never lose your purse or keys ever again. To start off with, let's open up the Find My app directly from the phone. You'll see it right here. Along the bottom, you're going to see four separate tabs: People, Devices, Items, and Me. In the Me section, you can adjust your settings, which include things like whether you will allow friend requests, whether you're sharing your location. You can edit the location name of where you currently are so that the phone knows this is called my home, or this is my work, or this is my friend's house. You can also customize your notifications right from this screen, or even at the bottom, help a friend out. So if one of your friends loses their iPhone, you can come down here and log in and help them find it. We're going to really do the majority of our work here in the devices section, so let's hop over there. You should see a list of all of the devices that are connected to your main iCloud Apple ID. If you see a device that you know is defunct or isn't yours anymore, you can click on it like this and scroll down to where it says Remove Device, right down there. Once you click Remove This Device, you'll be prompted to enter your Apple ID password. Put that in, and the unwanted device should disappear from the list in just a few moments. If you'd like to change the name of any device, that has to be done from the device itself. You can generally go into your Settings section here, into the General section here, and click on About. Right here it shows the name of your device. Clicking in that section will allow you to name it anything that you want. Mine is called TMW, which stands for the Mac Whisperer. On a computer, it's a little bit different. You'll need to go into your System Preferences and go into the Sharing section down here and change the name there. If you want to change the name of your AirPods, the first step you have to do is you have to put them on. Once they're on and connected, on the device they're connected to, go to the Settings section, go into the Bluetooth section, find them in your list, and click the little eye that you see to the far right side. From here, you can click on the Name section up at the top and call it whatever you want. Let's hop back over to the Find My app. While you're in the Devices section, clicking on any one of your devices will open up another page. It will show the location on a map, and it will allow you to play a sound to that device, get directions to that device, or set your notifications for that device. It's also from this section that you can track a device if you've lost it. So when I lose a device or can't find it, my first stop is to look in the Find My app and see if it's at home or somewhere else. If I can't locate it right away, I'll play a sound to see if I can hear it. If I still can't locate it, I'll scroll down here and I'll mark it as lost. This will allow me to put a message on the screen for anyone who finds the device, which can include my phone number, or an alternate phone number if the phone is what I've lost. And it will also lock the device so that a passcode is required to get any information off of it. Then lastly, if I'm unsuccessful in locating the device, I can erase it to make sure that none of my data is floating around and available for other people to get a hold of should they find that device. In addition to your own devices, if you have family sharing activated on your account and you're an adult or an organizer of the family share, you can see the devices of everybody else in your family. This is great when your son misplaces his phone and your wife can't track down her iPad. To check your family sharing settings, start by going into the settings here, and then click on your name at the top, and click on the family sharing section. This should show you all of the details and all the things that you've got shared with your family, and you'll notice location sharing, which if you have turned on, will allow you and the other members of your family to find each other. Right here, you can see whether your location is being shared or not. If you would like to share your location with a new contact, click the plus button in the upper right corner like this. You can share your location with anybody. Simply click the Share My Location button here and then choose who you'd like to share it to. If you'd like someone else to share their location with you, they have to do it from their device, but they can do it right from that same area. Once you've set up family sharing, you can come right back to the Find My app and we can go over to the People section. In the People section, you'll see all of the members of your family or anyone else who shared their location here in this list. If you click on any one of these people, it will show them on a map and it'll give me options of contacting them or getting directions to them or even getting notified when they leave or arrive at a specific destination. And lastly, let's head over to the Items section. In order to set something up in the Items section, you're going to need one of Apple's new AirTags. They cost about $25 each and they're about the size of a quarter. Once you've got your AirTag purchased and you take it out of the box, just bring it close to any of your other Apple devices and you should see a connect button like this one here. Clicking on that connect button will allow you to give your AirTag a name and immediately begin tracking that device. Just like when you're in the Devices section, from the Items section, you'll get options to be notified if you leave one of these items behind. The Notify When Left Behind feature may seem annoying the first time you see it, but if you customize it and make sure that locations like home aren't included in the list, then you're going to find it prevents you from losing your stuff, which is a step better than having to use Find My to locate it. One of the best functions of the AirTag is the way that you can use the Find option up here to help you pinpoint the location of an item. The Items tab will give you exact directions and an arrow to help you find your lost item. Isn't that cool? So easy, even when something's in another room or another part of the house or underneath a couch cushion. Now let's hop over to the computer to see what Find My looks like over there. The app Find My was first released for Big Sur, which was macOS 11. If you have an earlier operating system, you may not be able to find it, but you can still access the Find My system from any computer and any browser. Simply go to your browser and go to iCloud.com. If the device that you're searching for is on your main Apple account, it's pretty easy to just let the computer auto-log you in. But if you're looking for something that's someone else's device, or device on a different account, you can click where it says use a different Apple ID to sign in and find the Find My section from there. From here, you can easily track your devices, but not people or items. That's reserved for the Find My app. You can see the Find My app here on my dock. That's the icon for it. If you don't see it there, go into your applications folder and find it from there. As you can see here, the Find My app is laid out and organized almost exactly the same way as it is on the phone. You'll see a People section, a Devices section, and an Items section. And you can easily click on Devices to locate any of your Apple products and click on the I to the right of that device to get options for playing a sound, marking it as lost, or even erasing it. Clicking here on the People tab will show you the locations of all of your contacts, and at the bottom left, you can easily share your own location. Clicking on the Items tab shows you your AirTags, and gives you the ability to get directions to any of them by clicking on them and selecting the little eye. It also gives you the ability to get notified if you leave them behind and change those settings. So as you can see, whether you're one of those people that misplaces their phones or other items frequently, or you're a parent who wants to keep tags on their wayward teenager, I'm looking at you, Christian, or whether you have AirTags attached to your keys, wallet, purse, or other important items, Find My has got you covered. You can use it from your iPhone, your iPad, your computer, or you can access a limited version of it on any computer, including a Windows machine, by going on any browser to iCloud.com and logging in with your Apple ID and password. And that's what we've got for today's lesson. If you learned something cool or new, hit that like button so that other people can find this video easily. And if you're not a subscriber yet, take a moment. Subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you always get notified whenever I post new content. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done in less time with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And also to prevent you from misplacing your phone and calling me in the middle of the night to say, "Can you track it for me?" And with that being said, I will see you next time.